Hey YouTube. In the last video, I showed you how you can create your own home manager module. And in the example, we had packaged our own shell script and then made a home manager module in order to have configuration options for our system and home manager. And in this video, I want to quickly go over some general tips when it comes to building packages and building modules and so on and so forth. When we go back to the source code from the last video, we had used some library functions. And of course, these are not pulled out of thin air. There is actually a Nixpkgs reference manual, and here you can find a lot of help when it comes to building home manager or NixOS modules and also for packaging. For example, on this line, we had set our session variable and we had basically concatenated the strings that are configured in this option up here. And this you can also find in the reference manual. So when you go to the Nixpkgs reference manual and you go to the lib section here, down here you have string manipulation functions. And when we scroll down a little bit, you can see here we have exactly the function we have been using to achieve that the contents of our array are put into a string and are separated by a colon. And you also get some examples here how to use the function and what will be the output. There are a lot of built-in functions here. For example, what's useful is the functions for attribute sets, and here we have list manipulation functions, and here we also have the option handling. That was also something we were using because you might remember we created our option in the home manager module with lib.makeOption, and there's also a reference here which explains how you can use this and what values are available to you when you build your own modules. And down here we have also the make enable option we have used up here. What you will also find in the Nixpkgs manual is basically help on how to build packages. So for example, when you go down to build helpers and languages and frameworks, you can see there's a lot of documentation separated by languages. For example, when we go down here to the documentation on how to build a Go package, you can see there is also a detailed description on how to do that. As you can see here, you have, dependent on the language the project is using, different builders. In this example, we have, instead of the make derivation function we have used in the last video, the build Go module function. And just from this little example here, we can basically start building a package. For example, building a Go package is basically the same as we did before. So we put the build Go module function as a function argument here, and then we can use this function here, and we can basically start to build out our project. For example, when I want to build a package from an AI project named Fabric, which is written in Go, we can just build our package similar as in the examples. We can just start putting values here. So we have the program name and we name it Fabric. And let's see, the most recent version is 1.4.55. So we set this to 1.4.55. Then in the example here, we have the source attribute we were also using last time. And this is fetching the source code from GitHub. So we can basically just copy that also over. And of course, we will need fetch from GitHub here as a function argument. And now we can just start populating our package from the Git repo. We just set the owner here and then Fabric. And as you can see, for the ref attribute, this is referring to version up here. So in order to be able to use the version number from this attribute, we need to make this recursive set. And then it stops complaining. And of course, the hash won't match. So we just leave that empty for now. When it comes to hashes, for example, that is also documented in the fetchers section. And here you have a chapter about how to update and obtain hashes. You can see here, there's also a section about the command we have used last time, which was Nix prefetch. And then you have different types here. Last time we used Git, but you can also just use a URL, HG, CVS, and so on and so forth. So when we use that in our project now, I will just copy the URL from GitHub here. And then we just say Nix run. And here we use the Nix prefetch Git command to obtain the hash from the Git repo. And when we have used the prefetch command, we get all of the information about the repo here. And we can just stack this hash here. And copy it in here. And when we go back to the documentation, you can see for Go projects, you will also need a vendor hash. And the vendor hash is basically an extra hash for the dependencies needed to build this project. And right now, we don't know this vendor hash. And this has also not been printed out by our Nix prefetch Git command. And NixOS has different possibilities how to handle these cases. So when we get back to the fetchers documentation and we go for updating source hashes, you can see here in the first section, there is a fake hash method described. And what this basically does is you can either set this to an empty string or you can use library functions which provide a hash in a specific format that will basically generate a dummy hash. And for now, I will just use the empty one. And that's basically all I need to do for my Go package here. So now I can just use our Nix build command. And when this is trying to build our project, you can see that the build process fails. And it fails because of the fact that we don't have provided this hash, but in the error message, we will actually get an output for the hash that was calculated by the builder. So we can just copy this hash over and save it and then try to build our project again. And I get the error again, but that is actually my own fault because down here we are in package and go package and I accidentally put the source code into the Rust package default.nix. So I will just quickly fix that. And the vendor hash needs to go down here because this is not part of the fetch from GitHub function. And now it should be building. And you can see Go is starting to download all the dependencies we need to build this package. And after downloading, it will try to build the project. And as you can see here, I have specified the wrong hash. And this is the vendor hash. So I will just update that and try once more. And now it starts building the package. Now we have a result folder, so we can just go for result bin and then fabric. Let's do a full example. I will just do a how are you today and pipe this into result bin fabric. And let's say we just use the pattern AI. And we get a response from the AI. In this case, Fabric also has an official package in the Nix packages repo. And when we compare this, you can see this is very similar, just with a few additions. We did not put any metadata and we also didn't put the LD flags. And these are just options for the Go compiler. Basically, this is telling the Go compiler to strip out the debugging stuff so we get a smaller executable. And the rest is basically the same. And we can do the same. Let's say, for example, we take a Rust package. And for Rust, this is also very similar. You can see here, instead of build a Go module or make derivation, we have Rust platform build Rust package. When we build a Rust package, we can basically do the same here. And for example, for Rust, we could just take the wastebin project, just like this. And here we can also take the fetch from GitHub function and refetch the Git repo in order to get the hashes we need. So here we put the ref attribute, also the hash attribute. And here I basically just fill them in, just copy and paste it. And when I try to build it, I get an error. Here it says cargo hash, cargo vendor dir, or cargo log must be set. And that's basically similar to what we had in the Go project. When we have a look at the example here in the Nix packages manual, you can see we need a cargo hash, and we can handle the cargo hash the same way as we did with the vendor hash on the Go project. So I just leave it empty and start building my project. And now it will try to download all the dependencies. And at the end, we get an expected error because we don't have a cargo hash. And now we can just copy the hash here and paste it up here. And then we just rebuild our package again. And now it's compiling. And now the package is built and we can just go to our result bin folder and execute wastebin. And that's running. And now we can just go to localhost and we can just, I don't know, paste in some code, select next here. And this is also working. So these were two simple examples on how to build packages. And I can only encourage you to have a look at the Nix packages manual. There are a lot of examples for different languages. And what's also a good place to learn is to just go to Nix packages and let's take Alacrity as an example. You can just click for the source and yeah, here you can basically see how packages are built. This is also a Rust project, but as you can see, this is much more complicated than the one we have used. But when you are insecure on how to build something, you can really have a look into Nix packages and just look for a similar package in the same programming language. And yeah, just have a look how other people build the packages. So that's it for now, and that's it for packaging in my video series here. In the next videos, we will have a look into overlays and overrides for packages. So that will come next week. And yeah, until then, have a nice time. Bye bye.